Hello and welcome to DrupalDude.com. Here is my posting on what Drupal is. Basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up a quick website in just a few minutes that has content and a couple menus and hope just give you an overview of what you can do with Drupal. The whole idea with this is to give you an overview of what Drupal is, what it does, and what you can do with it. I have here a standard website or a standard Drupal installation. I haven't done anything with it. Basically, it says I need to create my first account. This is what happens when you install the database and install the files. So, first of all, we're going to create first account. And we'll call this admin. And admin at... This first account is the super user, I guess you would say. They are numero uno. They can do anything they want with this, with a Drupal site. They are user number one. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a password. Essentially, what Drupal did though, if I go and check my mail, they actually sent me a scrambled up message with a password automatically in there. So this automatically right now, if I go to my mailbox, there's going to be a message there from this website saying, you know, here's your username, here's your password, and it because I typed in that email address. So it's already starting to work behind the scenes. But I want a password that I can easily remember. So that's why I do that. And the time zone, I'm at -4, I hit submit. All right, so now basically I have a Drupal installation with one user. Now I want to add an article. Create content. I'm going to create a page. And here you'll see page and story. Essentially they're the same thing. It's a node in Drupal terms, but they're trying to make it cross, you know, be backwards, grandfathered in, whatever, because, you know, some people, okay, here's a page and here's a story. So essentially they're one and the same in this case. So if you want to set up different pages, you can do that and then have different stories within those pages. But hope I didn't confuse you there. I'm going to create a page. This one's going to be about, and we've got some stuff here. Some text. Publishing options. I want this to be on the front page. Actually, I don't want this to be on the front page. What I want to do is I want it to be in the menu, and this is about us. And this is going to be in the primary links. If I look up here, you'll see primary links. And I hit submit, and you'll see I have about us on the front page. Still nothing on, no articles on the front page. So now let's go and create, and this is going to be the first story. Put some spaces in here, make it look a little better. Publishing options, promote to the front page, hit submit. I go home, there's my first story. So essentially what I've just done here is I've created first story. I can click on it, there it is. Go back home, I can read about us, there it is. If I want to make any changes to it, because I am logged in and I am the administrator, I can go in here and edit it. And let's say, I didn't want that paragraph there. I wanted it down here. And we don't need that. That looks like a mistake there. And now when I hit, we can preview it, make sure everything looks all right. Now when I hit submit, you can see it switched the two paragraphs around. So that's what Drupal, how easy it is to add articles. We'll add one more just for fun. Oops, we'll add another page here. And second story. And let's make it two paragraphs. Put it on the front page. Hit submit. And if I go home, you'll see I have two stories here. And if I want to read about us, I can read about us. So within, just a few minutes, I already have I have a page and two different stories on a Drupal installation. You do have various things here. We have content management here. We have site building. We have site configuration, clean URLs, date and time, file system, user management. This is where you can set up different roles for different people. And then you have the logs. So that's really Drupal. We'll play around here a little bit more. If I wanted to add a module to it, say I wanted to add a contact, hit save. Now you see here I have contact form here. I don't know if you probably didn't see it earlier. I should have pointed that out. And I'm going to add a category, and this one is going to be website feedback. It's going to go to me, and this can go to multiple people. DrupalDude.com, and I hit submit to go to menus. And here it is, contact. I'm going to enable it. I'm going to put it up in the top again, the primary link, so it's up here. And now when I click on contact, you can see it has message, all that. Nice thing about this is it hides the email address, so spammers can't go and scrape the email address. So now I have an about, a contact, and stories. Pretty simple stuff. Now I want to change the look of it. I can do that. I go to themes, and we want it to be, we'll go with push button. And now you can see I have a completely different look for it. We can go back and let's choose Marvin. Again, another completely different look. All the functionality is still there. And I'll show you a couple other sites that I've done just so you can kind of see how far you can go with Drupal. This particular site, we'll go home here, is an island off of Puerto Rico. And essentially what we have here is we have an island map and it integrates with Google Maps. All these are different stories or pages, nodes within Drupal, so I can click on, we'll click on that one. Oh, Secret Beach, that looks pretty good. Let's go there. And it's going to Secret Beach within Drupal, and now here it is. I can zoom out. All within Drupal. I can look at these photos if I wanted to. The other thing, whoops. The other thing that it has on here is collapsible menus. These are all the attractions that are there. Here's all the beaches. And as we add beaches to it or attractions, it automatically adds it into the menu on the right there. Again, it does this all automatically. We have a photo gallery. We have reviews. People can review. And then we have listings of lodging and the restaurants. And the contact form, I just showed you. Yeah, there's the contact form. Then we added Google AdSense within it too. Here is another one that I just set up for somebody. And this one is a mortgage. This one's more of a marketing type. So it's not going to be a whole lot of content on it, but he has here commercial loans. And once it pulls up here, here's all of the commercial loans. And here I can click on this one and it gives me more information about that particular commercial loan. Or if I wanted to do residential loans, refinance, I can read about that. Now what he has here is his contact form is a little different. I created links that actually go to, now it says contact Loli Lanzo. So you can even go through and customize it from the default installation. And like I say, this one, I added a PHP script to it for mortgage calculation. So you can integrate things within it, videos, anything, PHP snippets, all that stuff. And then finally this one, this last one, Get My Estimate, is a, we send out direct mail to people that want to have work done on their house. And it would lead them to this website and we can keep track of all the leads. So they have a free, each builder has their own separate website with different pages on this. So it's almost like websites within websites. And the big key is they have an estimate request where they can actually go through and estimate the request. So that's Drupal in a nutshell. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on DrupalDude.com.